Today in the Music Day program, my dad is a music fan. He has many records. He just sat and began to play the drum set in front of us, six-year-old kids. In order to get to the farm in winter, we had to break the ice first. We first had to walk knee-deep in snow through a field. Hello, we're the Omodada Gee band. And what are we going to do today? To spend some time together in this studio. The Omodada Gee project is the Ternopil duet of Lesyk Omodada and Oleksandr Pakhomov. Musicians do not know exactly what format their future joint developments will take, but we can now say that the guys are creating psychedelic music. They work in alternative, grunge and trip-hop styles of the 1990s. My dad is a music fan. He has many records. I have listened to really cool bands since I was a kid. Rock or the Beatles. In 2002, I began to play in different bands simultaneously. I can say that G was simply a sex symbol of the Ternopil rock stage. He had the G's band. That was later. I remember when I was six, my parents sent me to an art school, but I learned drawing there. Despite this, we had such a subject as collective music playing, when each child was given some musical instruments to perform primitive notes. I was given a tambourine, and I played boom, boom, boom. We had a drum teacher called Stepan. He just sat and began to play the drum set in front of us six-year-old kids. He played with his hands and feet. My jaw just dropped, and I immediately wanted to be able to do what he did. When I was a first-year student, Oleksandr contacted me actively via social network. Then we decided to just walk through the woods and forged our brotherly ties. We realized that we had a lot in common, I mean interests, and it was cool to hang out together. Then we went to visit our friend on the farm. It was winter, it was summer, and we went to record a track, to try. And Lesyk suggested we record a joint track. We took the device outside and there was nobody around. We took out the equipment, turned it on. We recorded the track. After this, we realized that things would go further. Summer was followed by winter, when there is nothing to do in Ternopil. Then the period of our first album came. We composed a song every week or 2 weeks, and then we went to the farm. In order to get to the farm in winter, we had to break the ice first. No, first we had to go knee-deep in the snow through the field, then to melt the ice in the firebox and then start working.
We
all did mini albums with 3 to 5 songs in each. Our first song, The Room, was from the album The Rooms. And I think that it started our search for the psychedelic sound that consisted of many layers, various samples, sounds inserted from the blues of the 1930s and other things. I think that it was after some trips abroad, some new impressions that we saw there, with whom we talked, what we listened to, and we wanted to try something new. The last song from the Beatles' Revolver album was called Tomorrow Never Knows. In 1967, this song gave rise to psychedelic music. This is music where various types of sounds are layered, distorted or layered backwards, forming a harmony. That is, it cannot be called a mess, but it's just a piece of layered music. And every time when you listen to it, it allows you to listen to some new details. And it's about some psychedelic experiences. They can be an inspiration by nature or something else. Most often, there are certain experiences, emotions, visions of natural origin. We were joking that it was psychedelic music with the minimum effort. And this last set was done in half an hour. We even called it that. I don't even know the style we're working because it includes elements of grunge, pop, and some folk. If we take a look at our works, there are lots of different things. We compose our own indie music. We also record it, arrange, and mix it. We do not involve anyone else. We do everything ourselves. Our concept is that when we record some things, we first compose this for ourselves. That is, we compose our tracks to enjoy them later. Accordingly, when someone writes that this is the best album, this is one more reason to listen to it and enjoy what we've done. What did you do recently when you lost track of time? I slept. Vertical or horizontal? Vertical. Mechanical or electronic watches? Mechanical. Is it possible that scientists will find the eighth note? What would it be called? I think they have already found it. This is a brown note, but I don't know its name. Tame Impala or Animal Collective? Wow, cool question. I would listen to them both live. What was the last track you listened to? By the way, Tame Impala, Let It Happen. What Ukrainian bands do you like? Bloom's Quarta. Take Two. This is our studio. We decorated it jointly with other musicians. It was a kind of a work party 6 years ago. There was an abandoned garage at this site. Nobody used it. We came up with the idea of creating a recording studio because we did not have the money to go somewhere and record our tracks. There are a lot of cool things here. For example, this keyboard is a cacophonator. We used it when we recorded a track with Tiktoo. My friend Timur gave me this decorative noisy instrument for my birthday. A smaller prototype of this noise generator. It's such a little thing. Can you hear anything? With this help, you can make certain noises in music, or even in voice in cartoons or advertisements, and to simply create various noises. The track Single Bird from the album The Third is about our friendship with Lesyk. Thank you. Thank you for watching and listening to us. That was the Omodada Gee Band.